4-H animal projects provide youth with an opportunity to raise market animals that end up in the food chain. The popularity of animal projects continues to grow and has spread to many non-agriculturally based families. The use of technology continues to increase and serve a valuable role in our society. Ultrasound provides a state-of-the-art approach to evaluating meat animals. Today's farmers and ranchers producing 4-H animals are using ultrasound information for the selection of their seed stock. Youth who raise 4-H animal projects are stewards of animal agriculture, since the animals they produce become part of the world food supply. The opportunity for youth to receive carcass information from packing plants today is limited. In many cases, youth livestock are processed in small, local packing plants. Typically, carcass data are not collected because most of these packing plant employees are not trained to evaluate the carcass. The lack of available carcass information means a lack of educational opportunities for 4-H exhibitors. By implementing ultrasound carcass evaluation, participants get introduced to more educational opportunities. Learning about ultrasound helps exhibitors understand the industry acceptability of market animals and how his or her animal compares to industry standards. The use of ultrasound as a tool to estimate composition of live animals was introduced to the livestock industry in the 1950s. Subsequent improvement in ultrasound technology has allowed for 90% accuracy when predicting 12th rib back fat in beef cattle and 82% accuracy when estimating ribeye area. A study in 1992 reported a correlation of 0.77 between ultrasound predicted intermuscular fat and carcass marbling score. Today's purebred swine producers rely on ultrasound data to estimate breeding values on their animals. The accuracy of ultrasound estimates of the 10th rib back fat and loin eye area in swine has been reported at 83%. A study conducted in 1997 indicated that ultrasound values are more accurate than visual estimates by trained evaluators. The same study determined that ultrasound predictions of swine carcass traits, hanging carcass measurements, and standing carcass measurements were the same. The popularity and acceptability of ultrasound has given sheep producers the confidence to implement the technology in seed stock selection. In a study conducted in 2000, ultrasound estimated ribeye area in sheep was reported to be 82% accurate. Ribeye area is an excellent predictor for lamb retail product yield. High accuracy and good correlations between ultrasound and actual carcass measurements make ultrasound evaluation a good tool to estimate carcass quality from a live animal. Typically, carcass data are collected after animals have been harvested, and it is difficult for youth producers to get into packing plants due to travel distance or regulations. It can take up to a week to get individual data on the animal. Ultrasound measurements are available to youth exhibitors in real time as the animals are scanned. In the information age, ultrasound makes sense because the ultrasound carcass measures are available as the animal is scanned. Quality animals based on industry carcass standards can be identified using ultrasound. The ultrasound carcass data can also be added to show ring evaluation to validate industry acceptability of animals. Groups of animals can be scanned during the same period of time, allowing for a fair comparison. Some keys to remember when considering using ultrasound are: carcass traits are highly heritable, which means the traits are readily passed from parents to offspring. If the parents of a market animal have industry acceptable carcass traits, the animal should inherit them. Genetics play an important role in carcass quality. Carcass traits are hard to measure in live animals. Typically, carcass traits are measured after the animal has been harvested. Ultrasound provides the opportunity to collect carcass measures on the live animal. Ultrasound accuracy depends on the animal and its environment. Genetics are very important, but if the animal has not been properly managed and fed to reach its genetic potential, the animal will not express the traits that are expected. Animals that are extremely dirty or have more than a half inch of hair or wool can cause the accuracy of the ultrasound to be lower. Animals that are clean and clipped increase the accuracy of ultrasound carcass measures. During weigh-in at the fair, market animals are scanned by a trained technician. The steers are scanned in a beef cattle chute. The exhibitor brings his or her animal to the chute so it can be restrained in a non-threatening manner. Vegetable oil is applied to the cattle between the 12th and 13th ribs and across the 11th, 12th, and 13th ribs. The oil serves as a coupling agent between the animal and the ultrasound transducer. The oil helps to remove dirt and air and provide good contact with the animal. Less oil is used on clean, short-haired cattle. The ultrasound technician places the transducer between the 12th and 13th ribs, looks at the screen of the machine, identifies the image by using carcass landmarks, and saves the image on the screen. The technician then measures the rib fat thickness by looking at the screen of the ultrasound machine while using the trackball to measure. Once the technician has measured the fat thickness, the cursor is placed on the ribeye landmarks and traced. The rib fat and ribeye area measurements can be viewed on the screen and recorded. Rib fat and ribeye area give an estimate of how much of the animal will be food for people. Excess rib fat equals less meat. The technician then places the transducer across the 11th, 12th, and 13th ribs and collects at least two intramuscular fat images. The images are interpreted and given a numerical score that can be used to determine the percent intramuscular fat or marbling. Cattle that have high levels of marbling usually produce steaks that are more tender and flavorful. Hogs need to be restrained for scanning in a chute designed for swine or in an alley with hog panels in front and behind the hog. Vegetable oil is applied at the 10th and 11th ribs. The 10th and 11th ribs can be located by the technician placing his hand behind the shoulder of the hog. The first five ribs are located under the shoulder, and a hand width is similar to the next five ribs. The technician identifies the carcass landmarks and saves the image. Hogs have three layers of fat. All layers must be measured to determine the back fat thickness. The technician then measures the back fat thickness by looking at the screen of the ultrasound machine while using the trackball to measure. Once the technician has measured the back fat, the cursor is placed on the loin eye landmarks and traced. The back fat and loin eye measurements can be viewed on the screen and recorded. Hogs with acceptable back fat and more loin eye area produce more food. To collect an ultrasound image on sheep, exhibitors will hold their lambs like they are exhibiting them in the show ring. Vegetable oil is applied between the 12th and the 13th ribs. The technician then measures the rib fat thickness by looking at the screen of the ultrasound machine while using the trackball to measure. Once the technician has measured the fat thickness, the cursor is placed on the ribeye landmarks and traced. The trait measurements are viewed on the screen and recorded. As with beef and hogs, acceptable fat and more ribeye equals more meat. The measured data for each species are entered into an Excel spreadsheet where live weight is included in the data to determine animal carcass acceptability. Animals that meet industry standards for back fat and ribeye or loin eye rank higher than those that don't and are worth more money. Through the 4-H program, youth develop and enhance life skills, such as goal setting, responsibility, record keeping, and cooperation, as well as building self-esteem. These skills are learned by doing. Introducing ultrasound technology as an evaluation tool allows youth to increase their knowledge about the quality of the animals they raise. Today's youth are not intimidated by the use of technology. As technology continues to be part of everyday life, it is important to use it as a tool to enhance the education of 4-H participants.